most recent example was there were posts about Pat Buchanan running for president on the internet. And I merely left a simple little statement stating that Pat Buchanan belonged to the Knights of Malta, and as a member of the Knights of Malta, has taken an oath of absolute obedience to the order and to the Pope. I also made the statement that the Knights of Malta is recognized by all countries in the world as an independent sovereign nation, not just an organization or a secret order, but a nation. As a member of the Knights of Malta, I said, Pat Buchanan carries a diplomatic passport for this nation of the Knights of Malta. The Knights of Malta are also well known, it's no secret, the militia of the Pope. They have two sworn allegiances, and nothing else can go over or supersede these allegiances. The first is absolute and total obedience to the order, and the second is absolute and total obedience to the Pope. When the Vatican feels that the Pope is in some special danger, or that the Vatican itself is in some special danger, the Swiss mercenary guard that is normally employed to guard the Pope and the Vatican is dismissed, and the Knights of Malta take position as the guards of the Pope and the Vatican. As a member of the Knights of Malta, Pat Buchanan could be called upon to perform this function. So I merely posed a question. Shouldn't the President of the United States have allegiance only to the United States of America and to God, and to no other country, no other person, no other organization, and no other nation? Well, I made this post very nicely, in very nice language. I made my point very well and was viciously attacked from all sides. Now, it's noteworthy that every single person who attacked me was a Freemason or a member of the Mormon Church. I had said nothing about religion, only oaths. Only oaths. But this time, I'm going to stay there. And I don't care what happens, come hell or high water, I'm going to stay there, and I'm going to continue to rub it in their nose. And this time, I'm not going to leave the net, like I have been used to doing. I backed up every post I've made with facts. When I didn't give facts, I gave sources or references. And when I didn't do that, I told people that it's very easy to find the information. Please go do it. I even challenged these Freemasons who said that there's nothing wrong with taking an oath to the Freemasonic Lodge, and it would not hinder their ability to function as President of the United States. I challenged them to quote those oaths in public on that list on the net. And they refused. They refused because they're lying. They also take an oath that says rather than reveal the truth, they must remain silent or lie. One of the oaths, which I have in my possession, states that these people have to give shelter and aid to any brother Freemason, no matter what they have done or what trouble they are in, unless and except they have committed murder or treason. Anything else, they have to protect them. Also, there's an oath that says they have to refrain, and I'm paraphrasing it, refrain from molesting each other's daughters and wives. All other daughters and wives are fair game. I have copies of these oaths. This is not some imaginatory fantasy that I'm flighting off in. And so do many other researchers. And then later, as you get way up in the higher degrees of the Scottish Rite and the York Rite, there's another oath that says you must shelter and hide and give aid to a brother, even if he has committed murder or treason. And it also says that if any brother of the order of the Royal Arc degree is running for political office, you must vote for that brother. You cannot vote for anyone else. And the oaths demand absolute obedience to the lodge and to the master of the lodge. And that is why they will not quote the oaths. And you see, when you're on a computer net, they can hide behind their computers. Nobody knows who these people are. They can hide behind their computers and lash out. And when they can't deal with the facts or will not deal with the facts, they make personal attacks. I just read a post that was sent to me a few minutes ago. Rather than deal with the facts that I had posted and argue a valid, intelligent argument, to present one's case logically and reasonably with facts and sources, the person raved about how many women and children I had killed in Vietnam. And I fought in Vietnam, folks. I killed a lot of men in Vietnam. I didn't kill any women and children, none whatsoever. And I sorely regret having killed anyone. And when I left Vietnam, I made an oath to myself that I would never kill another living thing as long as I lived. And I've stuck with that so far and hope to be able to stick to it until the day I die and way beyond. And there's a reason that people are like this, because people, for the most part, are mindless sheep. The Illuminati are absolutely correct. I have discovered this. It has been one of the greatest disappointments of my life to discover that most people, the people that I have been battling for, the people that I have laid my life down for you can be sure that when the New World Order comes into power, my life is forfeit for the work that I have done. It has been the greatest disappointment to find out that they are absolutely right about most of what they call the masses. Whenever you hear somebody use that term, they're usually one of them. Are nothing but cattle, sheep, mindless animals, stakes on the table and beasts of burden by choice and consent. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's true. It's because from the beginning people are taught to be stupid, taught not to think, not to challenge, taught not to ask questions, why is it that we are told when we are young that we have to go to high school and then go to work for somebody? Why aren't we taught anything about money in high school? Why aren't we told that we don't have to go to work for somebody, that we can go out and begin a business of our own and not be dependent upon other people? Why aren't we taught to think properly, to question everything as we are supposed to do? What happened to Socrates? What happened to Aristotle? Where are they when we need them? Why is it that you think you have to marry the cheerleader and have 2.5 kids, buy a brand new Chevy, and mow the lawn every weekend? Who says these things have to be, and why do you eat it up? That's what I want to know. Why do you think that just because you belong to an organization, you must defend it rather than question it, especially when you don't know anything about it? And I'm talking to all you stupid, absolutely empty-headed Freemasons out there who joined an organization you didn't know anything about because you were proselytized by a friend or a business acquaintance. And don't tell me you weren't, because that's the only way Freemasonry ever gets members. Nobody even knows it exists until somebody comes along and pats you on the shoulder and says, John, we've been friends for 4 years. It's about time you joined the lodge. Oh, and I know you all say you don't proselytize and you don't go out and recruit members or seek new members, and you are liars. I'll say it right to your face through this microphone, or if your nose was 2 inches from mine, I'll still say it. You are barefaced liars. If you didn't do that, you wouldn't have any members, and you damn well know it. For all you know, it could be an international organization for the importation and the sale of pot to all of our children. And many of you will stand up and rant and rave and say, this guy is loony. We don't sell pot. How do you know? You haven't gone through all the degrees yet. And I can assure you that even if you're a 33rd degree Freemason of the Scottish Rite, there are degrees over you. For beyond that degree, they disappear behind what is called the veil. See, I know more about your order and your lodge than most of you ever will if you live to be 210. You don't even understand most of your own ceremonies. You just go through them because that's what you got to do to get the next degree and be loved by your brothers. You are part of a subversive organization that is destroying this country from within. You see, this country is not being destroyed by some invading army. It's being destroyed exactly as our forefathers said could be the only way that it would be destroyed, and that is from within. Most of the people who have had a hand in the destruction of this great nation have been Freemasons, members of the Rosicruci, members of the Knights of Malta, the Golden Dawn, Templi Ordo Orientalis, and I could go on and on and on. B'nai B'rith, that's a biggie. And B'nai B'rith doesn't mean Jews any more than Freemasonry means Lutherans. And there's another big player in all of this that most of you have never heard about, and that's the Order of St. John of Jerusalem. All of these organizations at their highest level are subversive. Their allegiance is only to the order and the worldwide brotherhood. They are citizens only of their own government and none other. And at the highest degrees, they take the oath called the Kol Nidre, and they mean it literally. It negates and does away with all other oaths. You see, the rites practiced in all of these orders were largely taken from the Jewish Kabbalah and the Jewish mysticism. And I'm not talking about a Jewish plot. Many Jews, most Jews, I should say, are not members of any of these organizations, and they go about their daily life just like all of you. Well, you see, one time in history, the Jews were the only people who preserved knowledge and passed it down. And they did so in secret simply because they were outcast, ostracized. They were forbidden to practice these things. And not all of the mysteries came from the Jews. At one time, ladies and gentlemen, the nation of Islam, headed by the Prophet Muhammad, was the greatest civilization in possession of the greatest knowledge upon the face of this earth. They had the only universities in the world at that time. And people from countries all over the world, including Europe, sent people to attend these universities because it was the only place that they could gain knowledge. The mysteries originated in the Middle East and have spread across the world. And so they take a large percentage of the mysticism and the religion and the magic and the occult knowledge of the people of the Middle East. Most Freemasons do not even understand that when they circumambulate the lodge, with the master sitting in the east representing the rising sun, that they are practicing an ages-old pagan rite to their true deity, which is the sun, the light, Lucifer. Albert Pike himself revealed the true God of Freemasonry. And he and many others have made the clear statement that Freemasonry is indeed a religion. But it is not the Christian religion. And many of them, fulfilling their oath to remain silent or to lie when the truth is presented to the public or before them, point to the Bible on their altar and say, "See, we are Christians. There's our Bible." What they will not do, ladies and gentlemen, is take you down the street to a lodge in a neighborhood populated by Indian immigrants, and I mean Indians from the Far East, India, on the Indian Ocean, where upon the altar of that Freemasonic lodge is a copy of the Bhagavad Gita. Oh no, they won't tell you that. For they're consummate liars, deceivers, and manipulators. And it amazes me how the public can continue to buy their bullshit for year after year after year after year. After they went to high school, they went to work. Or they went to college for 4 years where they were indoctrinated into what they are to believe and propound to the general public, and then they went to work for someone else. Amazing. Absolutely pathetic. A nation of children. And it used to be a time when the sheeple could go to work and bring home some real money. And they used to save their money. They weren't such sheeple as they are today. It was not considered honorable to be in debt. And if you were in debt, you tried to pay it off as quickly as you possibly could, and you never tried to intentionally go into debt. You had to be forced into debt by some terrible catastrophe that happened to the family. Most people who ever came to this country came with the idea that they would work and save their money until they had enough to start a business of their own. Today, our children are taught that they have to go to school in order to work for somebody else because they are not smart enough to start a business of their own. And the parents help them learn this lesson. For the parents are practicing it themselves. It is pathetic.